Good morning everybody and welcome to a new video about Xamarin. This video is about Xamarin.iOS. Before we learn how to create an iOS application with Xamarin and C#, it is important that you know what are the requirements for iOS development. First of all, you need a Mac computer. This can be local or remote. For example, you can take advantage of cloud services that provide you with a remote Mac. This is important because a Mac computer is required to compile and build the application. This is for the Apple policies. On a Mac machine, you need to have installed Xcode and the Apple SDKs. Then you need to install the Xamarin.iOS components. The easiest way to get Xamarin.iOS components installed the proper way is installing Xamarin Studio or Visual Studio for Mac Preview. You also need a developer account. For development, testing and debugging purpose, you can create a free developer account. Then when you need, or when you want, or when you are ready to publish an application to the Apple Store, you need to subscribe for a paid developer account. You also need the so-called provisioning profile and certificates that will be generated by Xcode when you configure your Mac for the first time. About developer account, you can simply use your Apple ID. There are some limitations, for example, you cannot deploy more than one app on a physical device with a single bundle identifier. You cannot use push notifications or other services from the Apple Store, but that's enough in order to get started. This is my Mac machine. I'm currently connected to my Mac remotely. And the first time you start Xcode, you need to create a blank iOS application. When the project is ready, you will need to first specify a bundle identifier, which is very important because you will use the same identifier on your iOS Xamarin project, either in Visual Studio or in Xamarin Studio on the Mac and Visual Studio for Mac. This is required if you want to test and debug your application on a physical device. The specification of the bundle identifier is not very strict if you just want to test and run your application on a simulator. The next thing we will have to do in Xcode is specifying the development team. Here you must add your Apple ID as the developer account. To do so, you have to go to the Xcode preferences, then accounts, and then you can add your Apple ID here. This will also make Xcode generate all the signing certificates and the provisioning profile required for the build and the compilation process. Now I'm in Visual Studio 2017 and I'm on my Windows development machine. By the way, the same steps apply if you work with Xamarin Studio or Visual Studio for Mac Preview directly on the Mac. I'm going to create a new project. Project templates for iOS are located under the iOS node. Then I can select Universal, iPhone, iPad, Extensions, and Apple Watch. I will select the Single View App iOS template. I'm calling this Send Email App. The goal of the sample project is showing you how to send an email from an iOS application written with Xamarin and C#. You will be welcomed with this kind of page. You can close it. Then in Solution Explorer, you will see the structure of a Xamarin iOS project. If you expand the references node, you will see the reference to Xamarin iOS library, which acts like a bridge between the world of C# and the native world of the iOS libraries, foundations, and frameworks, such as Cocoa. The appdelegate.cs file is the main entry point for the application. This should never be changed unless you need to add some initialization code. In iOS, the project properties and the application metadata are specified through the info.plist file. Visual Studio provides you with a convenient editor where you can specify important properties such as the application name and the bundle identifier that we were describing before when we were inside Xcode. So in my particular case, the bundle identifier becomes Alessandro Del Sole dot Xamarin app. I can specify the version number, I can specify the orientation, I can specify if the application must run on the iPad, the iPhone, or both, and I can also specify the minimum system version. The entitlements plist file is where I can specify some capabilities for my applications. This is not always necessary. And in the documentation that you can reach at developer.xamarin.com, you will find more detailed information. Okay. Now, let's take a look at how you design the user interface in Xamarin iOS. The first thing you will notice is a file called main.storyboard. In iOS development, a storyboard represents a flow of visual elements and pages. Here you have a designer. You can select a specific device for the preview, for example, the iPhone 6. You have a toolbox here where you can drag controllers and controls and data views and windows bars and gesture recognizers. For example, I can add a text view here that I can use to display a message to my user. If I press F4 to open the properties window, I can make changes to my control. Identity is a very important field because I can specify a name, so I can write for this subject label. I can provide the text, enter subject, I can resize, then I can drag a text field. And then I can drag a button. Okay. I can enter a name for my text field, which is called, for example, subject box. My button control will be called send button. And its content will be send. Okay. For a storyboard, you also have to think about a view controller. One is provided by default. A view controller is where you write imperative code to interact with your user interface. For example, I will use some objects from the foundation libraries. There is a number of objects that are already referenced from the foundation libraries of iOS. One is UIKit, which provides all the infrastructure for designing the user interface. Another namespace is called foundation. Another important namespace, which is the one we will actually use, is called Message UI, which allows interacting with applications and pieces of user interface specific to messages and email messages. The Message UI namespace provides an object called MF Mail Compose View Controller, which I call Mail Controller. This controller allows accessing the email application on iOS. You can see a number of method. The most important here is viewDidLoad, which is raised once the user interface has been rendered on screen. Any additional code can be written here, but must be done after the call to base.viewDidLoad. For example, let's add an event handler that will be raised once the user touches the send button. We can do this by using a reference to the control, and we can do this exactly as we would do with C#. The only difference with other platforms is that a touch gesture is recognized through the touch up inside event. I can specify an event handler in this way, and here I can write the code that will open the default mail application. First of all, I must verify that my device can send an email. I can do this by checking the content of a static property called canSendMail, like this, mfmail composeViewController.canSendMail. Then I can create an instance of the mfmail composeViewController, and then I can populate some properties of my object, like this. I am calling a setToRecipients method, which receives an array of string where I specify the email addresses of the recipients. Then with setSubject, I specify the subject of my email. In this case, it is retaken from the subject box control and its text property. SetMessageBody allows me to specify the email body, and then I can also take advantage of the finished event to release the instance of the controller by invoking dismissViewController. In order to show the specific controller, I need to call presentViewController, passing the instance of the controller I want to show, a boolean value that represents if I want an animation over this, and a delegate as a callback, but in this case I do not need one. When I'm ready, I can select either a physical device or the iPhone simulator, and then one of the supported images for the simulator, or in the case of a physical device, if any, Visual Studio will detect the physical device I can deploy my app to. Let me select iPhone simulator, then I can press F5. It is worth mentioning that compiling a Xamarin iOS application will require some more minutes. This is because it needs to connect to the Mac and the compilation occurs remotely. So this is the iPhone simulator running. And this is the sample application. Now, if I entered some text here and I press the send button, iOS will start the default client application to send an email. On the simulator, this kind of application is not available, so clicking send will not show anything, but you can test this on your physical device, which is always recommended, of course. So in summary, in this video we have seen how to configure the Mac machine for development, including a project configuration you need to do in Xcode. Then we have seen how to create a Xamarin iOS project. We have seen the structure and properties of a Xamarin iOS project. We have seen how to design the user interface. We have seen how to write C# code to access the APIs. Don't let's forget that writing C# code is the biggest benefit in Xamarin. We have taking a look at the info.plist file, and we have seen how to select the target device for debugging and testing. Thank you so much for watching this video.